Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Brethren from the Dublin, please, can we see your face, please? God bless you. Sir, Shalom.
Yes, ma'am.
Please, can you open the prayer for us? God bless you.
Okay.
Children, God bless you all.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we want to worship and bless your name. We want to worship and bless your name. We want to give you all the glory, for you are gathered in your presence one more time. We give you all the glory, all the honor for your children who are gathered today, Lord. Thank you for what you've done for us, Lord. So let us open our mouths and worship and adore the Lord for making us to be alive this morning. It's not by our power, not by our mind that we are alive. Let us give him all the glory, all the adoration. Open your mouth and pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We're going to ask the Lord to have mercy upon us in different ways we have been. In any way we have lied, we have disobeyed, Lord. We're going to ask him to have mercy upon us. Begin to pray, Lord.
Father, in the name of Jesus, ask for mercy. In any way we have sinned, we go and finish our glory. In any way we have sinned, in any way we have sinned, and we are not supposed to.
In Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Brethren, we're going to invite the presence of the Holy Spirit today in our service to come and take control, come and be the leader, come and be the head of this service today, to go by that we can sit and listen to the word. Invite the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus.
Father,
destroy every plan Satan has against us in this ministry. Anything he's planned against us, and we don't hear the word of God, we are going to cancel every of his plan in the name of Jesus Christ. Begin to pray. Let us commit our teacher, Sister Caroline, into the hands of the Lord, that she will speak the word that God lay in her heart. God will speak through her to tell us the word we're going to hear, the word that will transform and change us, because I will not be the hearer alone, but the doer. Let us begin with prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we worship and adore your name. We give you all the wisdom for making us to be alive today. Thank you for us all gathered among the living. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for our life. Thank you for the mantle of solution prayer ministry. Thank you for what you have been doing for us. Thank you for our life. Thank you for everything you have done for us, Lord. Thank you for our life. Father, Lord, in any way we have sinned against you, have mercy and cleanse us from every sin. Let this sin not be used against us, Lord. But as we worship and adore your name, as we listen to your word, may you be magnified and may you join us down here in the presence in the name of Jesus Christ. May your presence overflow, take over this place. May your presence be filled, that there will not be any face was in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, mighty Father, for this day. Thank you for hearing us. Thank you for the service today. I declare this service open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. As you have declared the meeting open, the Lord has declared heaven open for you, for every one of us, and all the children of the Most High God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Children, we are welcome today again to our Bible study and our fellowship this evening. And I pray that as we all come this evening, God has something special for you. You will receive it and you'll be a blessing both to your parents, to the community, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where is Sister Sharon from Dublin?
She's coming.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Jesus in worship for 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes, please. And will children, please, can we all rise up to worship our God as Sister Sharon lead us in worship for 5 minutes? God bless you.
We are on Father, mighty name of Jesus Christ, O Lord, my Father, as we're about to praise and worship you, Father, Lord, wear the garment of praise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May I sin not hinder our praise and worship unto you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never
Oh,
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Sasha Allen, God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, Dublin people. Are we hearing us?
Yes.
Okay, God bless you. Before we go into today's lesson, God bless you. Start the praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is everybody hearing me?
Yeah.
Okay. Before we start today's lesson, I want to ask for our younger ones. We sent out the printout. Do we print it out, our mommy and daddy? Do we print that out for our children?
Yes.
God bless you. Sadiqa, did you print it out for our children?
Yeah, I did. Like I told the children here that when they get home, their mom should write it out for them. So I print it out for my children anyway when I go home.
Oh, okay. Did you bring it for them? Because they are supposed to be doing something with it.
Oh no.
Okay, Sister Maria. Samaria. What's happening? There is a liar. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Samaria, did you print it out for Samuel and Divine?
Yes.
Sister Emanuela.
Yes, I printed it out.
Okay, that's fine. So for the children, I want the children that are below the age of 6. I want to give them their assignment so that they can be working on it while the older ones are listening to the Bible study. Is that fine? Mommies and daddies, are we okay with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Stataya, please, every one of us that have children below the age of 6, I want us to, what we asked to print out, I told us to bring 5 different colors.
Yes.
So I want us, I'm going to show it now.
Five colors.
Hold on, please. Just give me a second. I'm going to share that screen right now. Can we see? Can we see what's on the screen?
No, man. No.
Yes.
Okay. That's for our little ones, our younger children. They are going to color every line with different colors.
Okay.
So let our younger ones be doing. They shouldn't mix the colors together. You can see when it is time, I'll call them to come and ask them. Lying, cursing, hatred, pain, death. First and foremost, I want them to start doing their coloring. Then when it is time, I'll call them to come and ask them their questions. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. God bless you. Sadukwe, please, you also help us with the children in Ireland, those that are younger. If there's any printout there, I want them to start the activity by coloring those words with different kinds of colors. Are we okay, Sadukwe?
Yeah, God bless you, man. The one you just showed us.
The one I just showed you now. I want the younger ones to be doing that. Why the adult we continue with our studies.
Okay.
It's for the younger ones, anyone that is below 6. Okay. God bless us. Praise the Lord. Now for our bigger ones. We are giving assignment that day. We are just going to take one before we go into today's who can tell us of the assignment for last week? Mr. Fortune, do you remember the assignment we were given last week?
Was it to revise how many? It was like the daily verses.
Yeah, the one our teacher gave to us last week. He gave us three assignments, but I just want one.
Okay. Justin.
No, she gave us three verses. Okay, who can remember? Shalom, look at you have muted. Let me unmute you. Yes, Shalom.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, can you remember the verse, the chapter, the verse that we're given yet last week?
Proverbs chapter 19, verse 18 says, "Bless your son and do not set your heart on his destruction."
Hold on, let's open it so that we read it together, please. Proverbs chapter 19, verse 18. Okay. Can we all open to that, please? Proverbs chapter 19, verse 18. Okay, you can read.
Proverbs chapter 19, verse 18 says, "Chasten your son and do not set your heart on his destruction."
Okay, can you explain to us a little bit of what you understand by that?
This verse is telling us that our parents are chastening us in the right way, mm-hmm. and that's like not put your heart on our destruction, that she correct us, but like they shouldn't look at our reaction.
Good. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, parents, we have to correct our young children with love. We should not look at their reaction when we are correcting them. As long as they didn't do the right thing, the Bible tells us to correct them. But when we are correcting them, we let them know what they have done wrong. And we are correcting them in love. It's not that we hate them. We want them to be better. That's why we are correcting them. Is that all right?
Yes, ma'am.
Do we all understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
Why are you muted? Good. God bless you.
There are some noises from the background. That's fine.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. It's a blessing.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Can you give her the second one?
Excuse me. I'm sorry. I was not.
Okay, but Stapis, can you remember the second verse?
Ecclesiastes 11, verse 9.
Okay, can we all open to that? Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 9, please. Yes. Can you read for us, please?
Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and in the sight of your eyes, but know that for all these, God will bring you in judgment.
Okay. Can you explain to us what you understand by that, please?
It means like to rejoice to God.
Okay.
And to walk in God's way.
Okay. The Bible is telling us that we should always walk in God's way. Why? Because God, there's a day we are going to give account to God. One day we are going to tell God all the things we do, because whatever we are doing here on earth, God is recording it for us in heaven. And we don't want to do anything wrong in the sight of God. So whatever you are doing, always have that at the back of your mind. You are not just doing it for anybody, you are doing it because of our God and of our Lord Jesus Christ. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you. Oh, I will not be able to take the third one because of time, because we want to go to today's lesson. Praise the Lord. Our younger ones, are we doing our activities?
Ma, you didn't tell us the colors we are to use, so like I don't know.
Okay. I don't know the color everybody has. I just have to bring five different colors. So okay. As long as you follow it differently, don't mix it together. That's what I want them to do.
Okay.
Just five different colors. It doesn't matter whichever color you do, but just make sure that you don't mix all of them together.
Okay, Lukman.
Is that clear?
Sister Caroline, please. Sister Caroline.
Yes,
can you bring it up again so that the can you upload it again so that some of the children.
I'll bring it up now.
Okay. Now look at it. Yes, ma'am. Lying. The first one is lying.
The first one is lying. Second one is person.
Hatred.
Pain. And death.
And death.
They all have different lines, so I don't want you to miss it together, children.
So
are we first, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So I shall stop the sharing now. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, we are going into today's lesson. Can we just have a word of prayer, please? In Jesus' name we prayed.
Amen.
Our Father in heaven, we thank you for gathering your children together this evening. We thank you because whenever we gather in your presence, you always have something to tell us, oh God, something that will make our lives better. Lord, I pray that you speak to us this evening what you want us to know, what you want us to hear in the name of Jesus Christ. And as we hear, I pray that Lord in heaven will not just be the hearer, give us the grace to be the doers in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us transform every children's life here this evening in Jesus' name, so that we can go out and also be a blessing to others. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Today's lesson, we are going to be talking about obedience. What did I say?
We're going to be learning about obedience.
We're going to know what is obedience. So I want us to open to our Bible, Deuteronomy chapter 30. I want everybody to open to our Bible, please. Remember, that we should know how our Bibles. I don't want us to be using phone for now. Praise the Lord. Okay, I'm going to read from verse 1 to 5. Are we all there?
Yes,
no, ma'am. 1 okay. to 5. Yes.
Yes.
1 to 5.
Yes, please.
1 to 5.
Deuteronomy what?
This one.
Deuteronomy chapter 30.
Chapter
30. Chapter 30. Yes, I read from verse 1. And it shall come to pass when all these things are come upon thee, the blessing and the curse which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all nations, whither the Lord thy God has driven thee, and shall return unto the Lord thy God, and shall obey his voice, according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, that then the Lord thy God will turn thy captivity, and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations, whither the Lord thy God has scattered thee. Verse 4. If any of thine be driven out unto the outmost part of heaven, from thence will the Lord thy God gather thee, and from thence will he fetch thee. Verse 5. And the Lord thy God will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed, and thou shalt possess it, and he will do thee good, and multiply thee above thy fathers. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm not hearing. Everybody's muted.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I want us to take this verse down. It's called a memory verse. And a memory verse is something that supposed, a Bible verse you're supposed to read and memorize and know it by your head. So I want everyone to write it down. Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. Did you get that?
Yes.
Okay. We are going to read it later, but I just want you to write it down now. So what we are learning today is what is obedience. I want you to listen carefully because at the end of the day, I'm going to ask everybody questions. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you. Obedience is wise submission to the will of those whom God has placed over us. That is anyone that God has placed above us. It's our will submission, wise submission. We are submitting to them. True obedience is an attitude more than an action. It's not just an action, it's an attitude. It does not involve carrying out our commands that would require us to violate or go against the higher law of God. We all know that no matter the authority we have here, God is higher than any authority. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so
yes, ma'am.
And when we say we are going to obey those that God has placed over us, but because God is higher than anyone he has placed over us, if that law, if that thing that the people are telling us to obey, if it is not against God, we have to obey them. But if it is against God, because God is higher, who do we have to obey?
God.
Who do we have to obey?
God.
God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God's laws are higher than the laws of our country, higher than the laws of any other person. The primary Hebrew word for obedience is shama. I want us to take notes. Primary Hebrew words for obedience is shama. Are we hearing that?
Yes.
Shama, which means to listen intelligently, to be attentive, to respond to a call, and to consent. Are we getting that?
Yes, ma.
It means to listen intelligently. It means to be attentive. It means to respond to a call, and it means to be to consent. Obedience is more than just mere compliance, but it is not slavish subjection or blind submission. That means we don't just obey blindly. You have to know what you are obeying. Is that right?
Yes.
So that we don't go and obey the wrong thing. If any, maybe somebody call us and ask us to go and do something that is wrong, we are not going to obey that because that will be going against the higher law of God. Praise the Lord. Okay, I want to give us two things. In the Bible, God uses two things to describe, two animals to describe kind of disobedience. God used the unbroken horse and the stubborn mule as example of willfulness. We can see that in Psalm 32, verse 9. He said, "Be not as the horse or as the mule, which have no understanding, whose mouth must be held in with bit and bridle, lest they come near unto thee." The mule is an animal. It's a very stubborn animal. It does not listen to instruction and does not obey others. Are we hearing that?
Yes.
Then the second one, the horse, is a very fast animal, but it runs and keep running until it is beaten before it will stop. God does not want us to be like either the horse or the mule. We were given ears to listen and to obey. We are the children of God. We will not be like the horse. We will not be like the mule that does not listen or that go faster than instruction. We as children of God, we listen to instructions and we obey according to the word of God in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. The memory verse that I was going to give to us in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8, it said even Jesus Christ himself, he learned how to be obedient. He was obedient to his father. The Bible says, though he were a son, yet he learned obedience by the things which he suffered. Jesus Christ, as God himself, he obeyed the Father. He was obedient to his Father. And we ourselves, we must be obedient to our parents, to our teachers in the school, except they ask us to do something that God does not like. Do we understand that?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
To obey God rather than men. Whenever men ask us to do something that's against God, we obey God. But if they are asking us to do something that is right, like our teachers in the school, like our mommies and our daddies, we have to obey them as good children of the Lord. And Jesus Christ will bless every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. We should always obey at all times. The Bible also requires us to obey our parents, our teachers, and those who are taking care of us. God requires us to obey the law of the land and to be obedient to any authorities. We must also remember that the law of the land, as long as it's not against the word of God, we have to obey the law of the land. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So from what I have taught now, I'm going to ask a little questions. Our little ones, are we still enjoying our coloring?
Yes.
I'm going to share a screen now, and I'm going to ask Sister Fortune, Sister Peace, Sister Shalom, Sister Sharon, Sister Dupe.
Yes, ma.
Please, is there anyone from Dublin from your side that is older that I can ask a question, please? Because I don't really know their name yet.
Okay, ma.
I need to.
What do you want to?
I'll need two people. I will share this question now.
Okay, Sharon and Benjamin.
Okay, Sharon and Benjamin. So you'll be ready to ask that question. Then, somewhere from Germany, you answer one. Blessing, you are going to answer one. Okay, God bless you. So I've shared a screen now. Please try and look at it.
Okay.
I'm coming, please. Just give me some. Okay.
Oh.
Children obey the law of the land.
No, hold on, please. I want to start from the beginning. Okay. Can we see what I've just shared now?
Yes, ma.
Yes, ma.
What did he say?
How can children obey the law of the land?
How can children obey the law of the land? And what is obedience?
No, that's him. What is obedience? Who is going to answer that for us?
You.
What is obedience? Okay, Sister Fortune. God bless you.
Obedience is when, like, obedience is when your parents tell you to do something and you obey it, but in the way of God. Like, if they tell you to go and pray,
yes,
and you say no, that is disobedience. But when your parents tell you to go and pray and you do it, that is obedience. Or when your parents tell you to go and sleep, that is obedience, and you do exactly what she says.
Amen. When it is time, because if your parents know better, he knows that tomorrow you are going to school. If you stay late, it might affect your school the following day. Do you understand?
Yeah.
If, for instance, you have a homework in the afternoon, maybe towards evening, and you know you haven't finished your homework, and your parents say, go and sleep. You have to explain to your parents, oh, I've got homework, I need to do it at this time. You understand?
Yes.
That's
ma.
Why we are told that obedience is not just, we are not a slave, we are not just obeying what you don't understand. Your parents may not understand that you haven't finished your homework, for instance, because you have to also obey your teacher in the school. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. But when your teacher, when your mom know you have done your assignment, and it's time for you to go and sleep, he said you should go and sleep, and because you don't want to go and sleep, you think, oh no, I don't want to go and sleep, you refuse it. Because your mother is thinking about you, thinking about your health, it is always good for you to obey. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody has any question there, somewhere? Did you understand that?
Yeah.
No.
No.
No, this was somewhere.
Yes, ma.
You understand
yes,
that?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Fortune, you are raising up your hand.
My question is that, you know how when you said that you need to obey your parents?
Yes.
What if they said that you should come, let us go and, like, for example, your parents told you to come and let us go and buy earring for you or something, okay. And you said yes.
Okay. You remember I said that when the law, I told you that God is higher than everybody, is higher than our parents, higher than the law of the land. You remember I said that?
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. So if your parents is asking you to obey something that is against the word of God, you are not bound to obey that. You have to obey God rather than men. Do we all understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Who can give me an example of disobedience in the school, for instance? Yes?
Not doing your homework. I have one.
Good. Sister Shama, she's supposed to be working. What is your sister's name again?
Faith.
Has she done her own assignment?
Yes, she does. Okay. She's just following what I do.
Okay. who will answer that? What is her blessing? I'm coming back to you. Her blessing? Okay, support you. Go ahead. Stavless is not ready for us yet.
disobedience is when, like, your parents tell you to come, let us go and pray, or now you need to wear this, like, dress. For example, disobedience is like when your parents tell you to wear this dress because you pick something that's not really good. Yeah. Tell you to wear this long skirt, and you say, no, I want to wear the short skirt. Basically, you're disobedient. And disobeying because you don't know that whether it's going to be cool. Because, for example, your parents tell you to wear a jacket, but you don't want to wear a jacket to school. But you don't, because your parents know that it's going to be raining or it's going to be cold, but you don't listen and you say you're going to be fine without a jacket.
God bless you. Did we all understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you. So, number two question. You're coming now. Can we see the screen?
No, ma.
You're not seeing it.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on, please. Can we see the screen? Can we see the screen now?
Yes.
Yes, ma.
You have seen it?
Yes.
Who is going to answer that for us? What is the primary Hebrew word for obedience?
I've got it.
Okay. It's like it's only 40. I'm seeing her hand. Okay. First, you hold on a little. Hold your a little. I want somebody else for now first. Please. Who is answering?
Mima.
Mima.
Praise the Lord. Okay. Yeah, I can see hands now. Now, okay, blessing first.
The primary word of obedience
is what?
Shama.
Okay, let me spell it for us so that we know.
S-H-A-M-A.
Did you get that?
Yes, ma'am.
S-H-A-M-A. Okay, now I'll go to Shalom. Shalom, you are going to help us to answer number three. I'll share that now so that you see it. Please. Hold on. Question three. Okay, cool. Let's see. Question three, what does Sharma mean according to our study today?
Guy.
Who's going to help us with that? Praise the Lord.
Benjamin said you want to answer.
Okay, Benjamin, please.
Sharma is Hebrew word.
What does that mean?
What does it mean? I'm not saying that. Who's answering? Benjamin? Okay, yes.
Sharma is a Hebrew word for obedience.
Okay, God bless you. But what does it mean? I said it. I gave up my 3-4 things. Okay, slash Shalom. Wait, I'm coming. Shalom.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It means to listen intelligently, effectively, and to respond to a call.
All of them. One. Thank you. God bless you. Okay, Star Fortune. Second one.
It means to listen diligently and to respond to a call.
Good. Last one. Rasamwe. Not the small one. There's one word I'm looking for, Sister Peace. Oh, Sister Shalom from Shalom from Ireland. Okay.
Attentive.
Attentive. Okay, there's the one more left. Who can remember? Who can remember Ireland? No, somebody have answered. God bless you. Ireland? Yes?
Come to tell me.
Go ahead.
No.
I'm not hearing you. Yes, Shalom.
Come on, say it. Yes, I'm not sure you said that.
Intelligent.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It means to consent. To consent. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God bless everyone that have answered. Let's give Jesus Christ a clap offering. It means you are listening. You are good children of God. God bless you. God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, I want to go to the number 4 question now. Yes, I want to go to number 4 question now. Hold on. Can we see the screen?
No. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What two animals are always disobedient until they are beaten?
Horse and moose.
Me.
One person say one. Don't say the two, please.
No, ma.
Okay. Second one. What you?
And horse.
Okay. Why? Who can tell us? Blessing. Why are they described as? Why did we use those two animals as disobedient?
Number one is horse.
Okay. Who can tell us what it says? Why? Why were they? Yes. Can you remember? Praise the Lord. Okay, I want you all to go open to Psalm 32, verse 9. Why I did my children back. All my children that are coloring, I want you, Samuel. Small Samuel, can you show me what you have colored? Sister Tanya?
Yes.
Please, ma, I want Isaiah to show me what he has colored. Good. Isaiah?
Yes.
Can you raise it up a little bit so that I can see?
You can sharpen the back and make another one.
Good. James and Victoria, I haven't heard anything from you since. James? James? Brother Dandy, I'm not seeing you. I don't know how old you are. Sister Edith?
Is 4 years, man. I didn't print it out. I didn't know.
Who is 4 years? Oh! What's your name? Blessing, what's your sister's name?
Her name is
Huh?
The red.
I didn't hear you.
Mother.
Oh, wonderful. God bless you. Thank you so much. Sister Edith. Oh, I didn't hear those ones. Thank you so much. So, children, you can see what is there. Lying tongue. We are not supposed to tell a lie. Jesus does not like anybody that lies. Do we understand that?
Yes, ma.
And then we are not supposed to curse as well. You know what is cursing?
Yes, ma.
You are not supposed to curse whether anyone that is older than you, whether it is your one that is your mate. You are not supposed to curse anybody because Jesus does not like you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And also, we are supposed to love. We are not supposed to hate anybody. Because Jesus loved every children of God. We are supposed to love our brothers and our sisters and our classmates. We are supposed to show love. Is that right?
Yes.
By the grace of God, I pray that we show love whenever we are in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes. No, I don't want to hear cursing from our mouth. I don't want to hear lying from our mouth. Our mommy and daddy will not want to hear that because God does not like it. And anyone that does that is going to receive pain and death from God. That will not be our portion in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. So, mommy and daddies, anytime our children and younger ones want to do anything, just like them. Let them keep peace and know that Jesus does not like anybody that lies. Whenever mommy asks you something, tell mommy the truth, tell daddy the truth, and God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
James and Victoria, can you hear me now? James, Brother James.
Oh.
Can you hear me now? How old are you?
Seven.
God bless you. I didn't have your... What's your mom's email? So that I can be sending something to her.
Bele.
Okay, Bele. God bless you. I'll send next time because I didn't have your... Then Daniel. Brother Daniel.
Yes.
Brother, yes. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, where's your own? I sent it to your mom.
Yes.
Show it to me, please. I want to see.
Yeah, that's a
friend. Oh, wonderful. God bless you. Thank you. Sister Edith? Sister Edith? God bless you, ma. I want to see...
Joshua.
I want to see his own.
Ma, sister is inside the bus.
God bless you. Sister Antonia. Sister Antonia, I want everybody to participate, please. God bless every one of us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, we are back now to, before we close, we are back to, okay, I think I'll just take this last one.
Oh, mama.
Number six. I'm going to ask this question and then we do our assignment. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, can we see the screen?
Yes, ma.
What does it say?
What do we learn about Jesus and obedience in Hebrew chapter 5 verse 8?
Okay, how you can tell me that, please? What do we learn about Jesus and obedience in Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8? Can anyone answer us, please? My brother from Ireland. Yes. Okay, Hebrews chapter 5 verse 8.
Okay, read.
So what do you learn from what we just said now? What do we learn from what you just read now? Please help us.
What is it? She said God was suffering. Talk louder. She can hear you.
God's son.
Who is the God son?
Paul.
He said Paul was suffering.
Hebrews 5 verse 6. Though he were a son, we are talking of Jesus Christ.
Okay, what did this mean?
Although Jesus Christ was suffering, he learned obedience at a young age. Even if you are young and you're suffering, you can still learn obedience.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Yes, Jesus Christ, he was a son of the Father and he learned obedience. He obeyed. So we are children. Even when we obey, and even if we bring us any little suffering, we have to follow the step of our Master Jesus Christ. We must learn obedience, and God will bless us as we obey our parents, as we obey our teachers, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. There is a little homework that we want to do now. Everybody, get your pen ready, please.
Everybody, get ready.
Praise the Lord. Now is it praise?
Yes, ma'am.
This is going to be a homework. But I want you to write it down.
Write a story of
how you praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are we seeing it?
How you were obedient to someone you can remember.
Write a story of how you were obedient to someone you can remember. It can be your mom, it can be your dad, it can be your teacher, it can be anyone. It's going to be a homework. Just write it down for now. I don't say you should say it now.
Write a story. Story.
Is everybody writing?
Yes.
The bigger ones, please. Also, write how you were disobedient, if you have ever been, which I know. And write how you felt when you were disobedient. When you are three, let me know.
Right. write a story and write.
Are we all writing?
Yeah.
Yes.
God bless you.
This. The end.
Who has finished?
Not me.
If you finish, let me know.
I'm finished.
Good. Who else?
This is gonna be hard.
Are we all finished?
Finish, ma.
Are we all finished?
Yes, ma.
God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So I've given all the bigger ones just two assignments. One is the memory verse, which is Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8. Throughout the week, I want you to learn it, read it, and memorize it. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Then the second one is this one that we just gave now. So when we come next week, by the grace of God, we will start with that one. Is that okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, who can give me an example of who we are supposed to, those that we are told in the study today, who are supposed to be obeying?
Me, ma'am.
Yes. Sir Shalom, Sir Fortune.
Our parents.
Okay. Go ahead.
God.
Fortune.
Yes, ma.
Who are we supposed to obey?
We're supposed to God's parents, people that are older than you, your teachers.
Okay. And those, yeah, James.
Start.
James. Yes.
Land.
Huh? I'm not hearing you. I want to hear you.
Of the land.
Okay, the law of the land. Yes, what? Who can give me an example of the law of the land? Isaiah, you raising up your hand. Who can give you an example of the law of the land? Yes.
Also, she gave an example.
Yeah.
Like a law of the land is like there's one law in Allah that the people should be free to choose whatever like present that they need. President that they feel is most comfortable for them.
Praise the Lord. Did we hear that? Did we hear that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Last one before we pray. Yes, ma'am.
Pay your taxes.
But you are not old enough to pay your taxes. As a child, you are meant to be in school at an age between the age of, is it 6 or 4, 5? When you are meant to be in school, you should be in school. Is that right?
Yes, ma'am.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Did we learn anything today, children?
Yeah.
What did we learn today, in summary? Yes. Yes. Yep, you muted yourself.
I left her now.
Yes.
What we learned is
that what we learned is that you need to be obedient to your parents so that you
can. If you don't obey, there's always consequences of not obeying. God will not be happy. Jesus will not be happy. Your parents will not be happy. And I pray that through obedience and our parents will be happy. Jesus will be happy with us. And we all get to heaven in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We are going to pray now. Amen. We want to pray. I want to ask, is there anybody among us, if you know you have not surrendered your life to Jesus, you have not given your heart to Jesus, Jesus Christ loves you, he wants you to be within him heaven at the last time. If you know you have not really saved, and you want to be saved, you want to pray together, is there anybody like that amongst us? Huh? Okay, we are going to pray, and we are going to pray as well as you are obedient to your parents. God will use every one of us to be a blessing to those outside that does not know God. You know that? People outside can learn from you. At school, they can see how obedient you are and they can learn from you. And God will make you a blessing to the generation, to this our generation in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's pray. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And Father, we thank you for what you have taught us this evening. Jesus Christ, we are happy. We want to be obedient unto you. You have given us example. I pray if there be any child here that have not known you, we pray that as they have heard your word today, you give them the grace to give their life unto you, and they will be a changed person in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And for every one of us, you have saved already, God. Wherever we have been disobeying, we ask for your mercy that you forgive us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You have taught us obedience now. We want to be obedient to you. We want to be obedient to your word. We want to be obedient to our parents, to those that you have put above us to be able to take care of us. Lord, we pray that you give us the grace to be obedient so that at the very end of time, we can make it to heaven and be with you wherever where you are in heaven forever and ever. In the name Amen. Of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So now we go and be a blessing to our parents. Even in school, people will see our example, and through us, they will come and know you. And a crown of glory will be for us because we have done what God wants us to do. Father, we thank you because we know you have heard and you have answered us. We will not just be hearer, we will go and be obedient, and we will go and be the doer of your word. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Shall we share the grace together in fellowship?
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, yes, abide with us now and forever. Surely, the Lord's goodness and mercy is following us all the days of our lives. Shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. Blessing and favor upon each and every one of you in Jesus' name. We all testify of God's goodness upon our lives in Jesus' name. And children, let's remember to always pray for our parents. Our parents are doing so much for us. We pray for them that God will answer them. God will answer your prayers in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. See you next week. I see you on Sunday tomorrow as well. Amen. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. God bless you.
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Say until you did not say off time. That's the problem now.
Okay, off time, eh? God bless you. Samaria, God bless you.
Okay, God bless you, man.
Bye.
God bless
you. Bye.
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 Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Santos, Santos, Sweden.
Oh.